The Astros rolled into town and took two games of their own. It's all tied up. We got a series. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Talking Baseball. My name is John Boy, and I'm joined, as always, by my co-host, Jake. He's in Denver. I'm in New Jersey. We're talking about the World Series, all tied up at two. Another game similar to Game 2. Game 4 has kind of mirrored Game 2, and did Game 2-3 kind of mirror Game 1. Some late runs to put the dagger by the Astros. Corbin takes a loss, and your kitty kind of looks like he was the man. So there's a lot to talk about going into Game 5 tonight. It is the Sports Equinox, Jake's third favorite day of the year. And this episode is sponsored by Stanley Bloom. That sounds like a furniture company. Stanley Bloom and Alexander Gonzalez. Thank you to Agons and S. Bloom. We appreciate it. Patreon.com/JohnBoyMedia. You can sponsor the next episode. You can join live with us. You can win a jersey or two each month. And thank you. Jake, how are you doing on this fine Sunday morning?
Doing fantastic, Jim. We're here doing fantasy football stardom or sit-em. Thanks for tuning in. No, we do baseball on this podcast. No football. And, yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's kind of like everyone expected. If everyone had to place a bet through four games who was going to have the best start for Houston, you'd say Jose or Keedy. And yeah. Baseball's an easy game.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Just, I love when things add up, you know?
Yes.
Because I'm not good at math, so I need things to just kind of, you know, lie where they lie. And Jose Urquidy going 5 shutout makes the most sense.
It's what we knew. And then it was what was the game going to be around that. So yeah. That's the story.
So, I mean, Zach Greinke going whatever he did, 4.2 one earned run.
Yep.
I mean, that's good. It's not Urquidy level.
No.
No, not at all. And then you had Verlander, 6 innings pitched, 4 earned runs. Bad.
Not great.
You don't want that. And no. Cole, 7 innings pitched, 5 earned runs. Give me Jose Urquidy.
Yeah, it's just, I mean, it's the tough part for Houston. It's can we roll Urquidy out there every day?
Yeah.
You know?
How quickly can he bounce back? Because you know,
kudos to AJ Hinch for not throwing Urquidy out there earlier. Because it's got to be tempting when you got that in the hole.
Uh huh. To sit on him until Game 4 is crazy.
And it's, so, I mean, AJ Hinch managing Houston and the Mets at the same time. It's just incredible what's going on down there right now.
Well, what I was playing disc golf yesterday and
sure.
Hanging out at youth flag football games and youth little league games.
You see anyone there?
Yeah, I hung out. I said hi to Todd Frazier and we hang out. But Todd's awesome, so that's cool. I mean, he was just like coaching his son's flag football game. It's like, you know. He's just a dad.
Do you have any input?
No, they had it. Dude, you know what's funny? His son is the age where, you know how in baseball there's coaches pitch?
Sure.
In this flag football league, I don't know how old his son is, probably 5, 6, 7. It's coaches QB. So like.
Oh, nice.
How fucking fun is that?
The dads won, yeah.
The dads are having a blast. I was like, this...
That would piss me off as a kid. How old are they?
Like 5, 6.
Okay, so yeah, that's still cool.
And a lot of it is handoff plays.
Right.
But every now and then, the coach just tells his 11 5-year-olds, "Go, everyone go deep." And
send
then he
it.
Just looks around and then throws it. I'm like, that's yeah. awesome. Give me a kid. I want a QB in a 5-year-old football league. I'd tear it up.
Ooh. If you have a kid in the Jersey Shore area, make sure you know where it is.
Yeah, always know where your kid is, I'd say.
Right. But
you don't want to lose your kid.
To get a kid so you can play football.
I was going to have my own.
Right.
It's a 5-year plan.
Okay. Well, numbers still kind of don't add up there, but we'll get to that at the end of the show, I think.
Yeah. Okay. Well, anyway, yeah, hung out. So what's this Mets nonsense?
I mean, we shouldn't do a whole thing on it because it is the World Series and it is the Mets. But, dude, Brody Van GM and Hinch are best friends. He was the best man at his wedding.
Oh.
So the Mets keep saying, hey, we've got this bombshell manager. It's like, okay, that's probably Brody Van GM's best friend then, A.J. Hinch.
Is A.J. Hinch a free agent?
I don't know Hinch's contract situation, but I think it's one of those things you can figure it out if you need to.
I think Hinch is like, yo, Brody, you're my friend.
Right.
I don't want to do business with you.
Right.
Because why would you want to join the Mets? Whatever.
Get paid a lot. You might have 2 rings after this. I don't know. But we'll circle to that. And
the Mets have a lot of talent. They just have one of the worst run front offices ever. I wouldn't want to dip my toe into that.
I wouldn't say worst run front offices. I'd say worst run organizations.
Okay. Whatever the difference is there, I don't really know. But
there wasn't one.
Yeah. They retired a guy's number just to change the headline. Did we talk about that on this show?
Yeah.
It's one of my funnier storylines. So anyway, Hinch, future Met manager, doing well for the Astros as they tie this up. And now the Astros get home field advantage as it goes.
Who's going to win the World Series, Jimmy? This is my favorite question to ask on this show.
The Astros. And I said, when the Nationals are up 2-0, I said, I think the Nationals are going to win the World Series. But if the Astros win the next two, I reserve the right to change my mind. And I have. And that's how this show goes. We're not First Take where we just have to lock into opinion and then defend it with all our might. I don't care. I'll flip-flop all over your ass.
Yeah, that's they've been calling you the flip-flop. Man, unreal. And if you're a Nationals fan listening, it sucks.
Yeah.
It sucks. I just had one of my weird analogies come into my head. Is like if a giant was invading your town, I'm talking like early 1200s, not a lot of technology, giant's coming in, he's about
don't
to
underestimate
your town.
The 1200s.
Oh, I never do. Dancing plague. But the giant comes into town, it's like, oh, the giant's here, he's gonna eliminate our town. And it's like, well, let's fight the giant. And then like, oh wow, first 2 shots you ripped out its eyeballs. And it's like, okay, we're going to take down the giant. And now the giant's just like pissed off. He threw one of his eyeballs back in. It still works.
I thought it was going to be like a blind giant. Like a blind giant actually can cause more damage because he's just waving his arms and stomping everywhere now. And you're like, this was better when he had an aim.
Right.
Yeah. Cool visual, Jake. Thanks for that.
Thanks for tuning in, everyone. We'll talk to you after game 5.
Isn't Blind Giant a band?
Could be.
Blind Giant. Yeah, it is. There's a couple. There's one called These Blind Giants. And the name of their single is Witch Magnet.
Mm.
So they're in deep into like that world of witches and giants.
It's a good time of year for them.
Oh, tough break. They have 0 monthly listeners.
Ooh. It's a rebuilding year for These Blind Giants, though.
Yeah, they just kind of figure it out.
Okay. Yeah.
You want to burn this game?
I can burn this game.
Burn, Jakey, burn!
Game 4 of the World Series. Winner of this game wins the World Series, according to J-Lo's fiance and myself, Patrick Kurt Corbain. Inviting the Astros to come as you are. In the nation's capital, top 1, Breggy Smalls with the juicy RBI single, followed by You Lay You Lie, infield single, Michael Brantley scored, 2-0 after 1. Meanwhile, for the Stros, Jose left the Nationals saying, you're kidding me. Jose Urquidy with 5 shutout innings. What a boost for Houston. What a blow for the Nats. Speaking of blow for the Nats, Robinson Chirinos, hang him and bang him, babe. 2-run gopher ball. Nats would push one across on a Soto RBI groundout. It's 4-1 into the 7th. Hey, bro, you a tits man or an ass man? Neither. I'm a Bregman. Alex goes all Denny's on him with the grand slam off my king, Fernando Rodney. It's 8-1, and that would be your final. Houston locks up the series at 2 games apiece.
You're kidding me.
You're kidding me.
Put that on a shirt, Houston.
Come on, Houston. Be better about
it. You're kidding me? Oh, that's pretty good. Also went with the little Kurt Cobain in the beginning, huh?
Yeah. Kurt Corbin, Cobain. It's all there.
Nirvana.
Yeah, I was on that cover of that album.
You were the baby.
Baby penis.
They found that baby and they like reshot the cover with him as like a an adult, like a 20-year-old or something like that.
Nice.
Some band did that. I met a girl once in Sandestin, Florida.
Nice, dude.
Yes, thank you. I was in 8th grade. I don't know how old she was. I'm going to guess 8th grade as well. Maybe 7th.
You guys still stay in touch?
Haven't stayed in touch since the 3 days that we hung out together. She was super into Kurt Cobain and brought out like this yearbook, a scrapbook that she made for Kurt Cobain and Nirvana. And then she like was showing me all the pages in the hotel lobby or whatever we were hanging out, and she started crying and stuff. And I was like, this isn't something you should reveal to the public about yourself.
Yeah.
But she was so young. And then I can never think about Kurt Cobain and Nirvana without thinking about that crazy girl who made a scrapbook and cried flipping through her own scrapbook. So thanks for bringing that into my head, Jake, on this Sunday morning.
Parenting's brutal, man. Like, when your kid gets locked into something, what do you do? Like, my mom had to be pretty weirded out that I was obsessed with Terrell Davis, the Broncos running back.
Like, and Bellinger.
Clay Bellinger, Cody's dad, the utility infielder, writing a paper on him in third grade. Like, yeah, that's weird.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know what you do if your daughter, like, flips through the scrapbook of the depressed singer who killed himself but used drugs and made good music. I don't know what you do. I think you
officially a parent.
You know what her parents said? You should show that to boys you meet. That's what her dad said, knowing that they'd scare him away.
Yeah. That's actually dad 101.
Yeah. Show this to that guy you like.
See, that's tough though. That's a double-edged sword, because what if she finds the one guy that's like, this is the coolest thing ever?
Let's cut ourselves. Then you're fucked. That's a bad move.
Jim, what are your thoughts on this baseball game?
Corbin blew it. Astros turned it on, man. I mean, Altuve 2 hits, Brantley 3 hits, Bregman 3 hits. I'm very happy for Bregman. I wasn't enjoying Bregman doing awful, to be honest with everyone. Like, I like that it hit the darkest of times, and the errors at third should have been the end of that. Game 3, him going 0-for-5, I was like, this kind of blows now.
Intentional walk. They kind of poked the bear there.
Yes. Intentionally walking to get to Bregman. We got to sad times. So I'm happy with that. Fernando Rodney did exactly one of the two things I asked him to do. It's either be lights out or be awful.
Yeah.
And this game met the status quo of this series. You know, hey, Nationals, you don't want to use anyone but Hudson and Doolittle. You need your pitchers to go 6+ so you can hand it over to those two guys in the pen. They didn't. I mean, Rainey comes in and walks 2. Rodney comes in, gives up a single, then the grand slam, then walks 2 more, and then whatever happened gets pulled. Like, that's what everyone kind of expected. They held it together for a couple days. We didn't expect that. But, I mean, this was this felt like, this is how this is supposed to play out, for me at least.
Hudson and Doolittle haven't pitched since game 1, which is kind of wild, just because they had the blowout and then they lost the last 2. And yeah, I guess that's got to be the hot topic in Nationals land right now is, I mean, yes, you're losing 4-1, but Alex Bregman's up. I mean, you kind of should go Hudson or Doolittle there to keep it a game, right?
With them not pitching the day before, I went to sleep last night and I woke up and did this, so I haven't seen any scuttlebutt. Like, I don't know what the conversations sure. National fans are having or Houston fans, but I would guess that's a conversation. Like, why with two on in the seventh inning of a 3-run game, like, nip this in the bud real quick and give the offense a chance. That's what I would guess.
Yeah.
Well, Rodney had been doing well, but he's not as good as, he's not your best guys. It's that high leverage situation. Use your high leverage guys in the highest leverage spot.
They clearly like Rodney against Bregman. That's who, when they intentionally walked Brantley, it was Rodney and Bregman. So they kind of like that matchup, but yeah, World Series, and when you see Bregman starting to get the bat going, you got to know that's not going to be a winning formula for you. I mean, they are down 3 runs, so I guess there's something there. Yeah, man, and the ever-important first inning. Astros put 2 up in the first. It could have been more if Rendon doesn't pick one and they get the double play ball off Chirinos, which he shows his face later. But yeah, man, it felt like when the Astros pushed 2 across in the first and then Urquidy held in the first, like, that was a win. Because, like, Urquidy could have gotten pulled. If Urquidy got in trouble in the second, they, like, would have pulled him. And you can't do that with Corbin. So once he got through the first, it was kind of like, you kind of did your job.
Urquidy went 5 strong, man. I was blown away that he was still in there.
His previous 2 performances as postseason, he didn't clear 50 pitches. So, I mean, you kind of assume that again. He's a rookie. He hasn't been, like, on a regular routine or anything. But, yeah, man, 5-inning shutout. Best start for Houston this World Series.
Are you worried about Soto?
No. No. I mean, Soto can go back to having an insane narrative with one big swing in Game 5 or Game 6 or 7, to be honest. But yeah, I don't know. You see him in that big spot, bases loaded. He gets the ground out and a run scores, but it's kind of like we are now nurtured to expect a lot more from him.
I meant like, you know, since turning 21, tides right. have changed.
Right. No, he's
I don't think he knows he doesn't know how to fit into his 21-year-old body yet.
Father Time is undefeated.
Yeah, for some.
No.
So you think Tuck Everlasting was fiction?
We just can't go down this road again.
You're joshing me.
You're joshing. Soto, Rodney to Bregman. Yeah, can't do that. No, not worried about Soto. I mean, he ends up having the only RBI and a walk. Rendon goes 2-for-4. Dude, look at everything surrounding them. Trey Turner goes 0-for-5. Eaton goes 0-for-3. Kendrick goes 0-for-4. Zimmerman goes 0-for-4. I mean, just nothing there.
Did you see the pitch Bregman hit the grand slam on?
Yep.
It's a pretty good pitch, right? Inside 93 fastball?
Well, it's kind of, I mentioned this last time that Smoltz said, like, it's kind of known that Bregman's approach is he looks middle in until he gets 2 strikes. So, I mean, it's tough to say. It's a low and in fastball from Fernando Rodney to Bregman. I'm not going to say it was a great pitch if, you know.
I would say it's an impressive swing still.
Yeah.
To drive,
really good.
To drive that ball. Did you see Verlander and Cole's reactions? You see Cole's reaction?
Yeah.
You think that, like, Cole has to lick Bregman's foot or something now? Definitely seemed like there was a bet in place, and Cole was like, fuck.
No, I think that look on Cole's face was like, game. Like, he went into his starting pitching for tomorrow mode right then.
Ooh, I like that. But Verlander kind of like slaps his arm like joking, like, oh.
Yeah.
So I think there might have been a bet going on. Because even when Bregman walks down the tunnel, Cole still like doesn't crack a smile.
Yeah.
He's like upset by it. I like that he goes into game mode.
Yeah, I think that's what happened.
I think I'm going to do a breakdown of it, and I'm going to do a fake bet, though.
Okay.
What should the fake bet I do on the breakdown?
Fake bet on the breakdown. God, I don't know. LSU, Bregman, they won yesterday. I don't know.
Okay, cool. Good. Thanks for the help.
We'll think about it.
Sit on a cake.
It's always a good one.
Yeah.
It's always a good bet amongst friends.
Yeah. You've had to sit on so many cakes in your day.
Cake sitter. Cake farts.
Jake. Jesus.
What?
Jesus. Holy cow.
What the F, David Blaine?
Astros are sitting pretty. They have home field advantage with their two best arms going. What storyline do you like more? Verlander and Cole are now in like bully mode because they got. And
right.
We don't get got. And they go like seven innings pitched each, two hits, like just straight dominance. Or the Nats are like, okay, bring us these guys. And they feast on them again.
Yeah, no, we love these guys. Just don't throw Urquidy out there.
Don't put Urquidy on that mound. Which storyline do you like better?
After tonight's game, if they just get to Cole again, like that would be wild. So I guess I'm kind of rooting for that. It would also be just as cool to see Garrett Cole go like 8 innings pitch, 14 strikeouts in a World Series game 5 in Washington.
Just angry, what the fuck mode.
It's like, yeah, you guys fucked up. You got Urquidy? That's what Cole's saying. You're kidding me?
Scherzer's on the bump tonight. Buck Johnson says Scherzer's going to dominate.
Yeah, Buck Johnson was all over me for loving the Astros, and he kept telling me to jump on the bandwagon. I'm glad I didn't.
Well, he says stay on the bandwagon. He thought you jumped.
No, Buck. Get your wagon out of here.
You couldn't jump onto a wagon.
I could jump onto a wagon.
What kind of wagon are you envisioning? A little red flyer?
Oh, no. I was picturing like Oregon Trail stuff.
Yeah, you can't jump onto that.
I could jump onto that.
Only if the side of it was Velcro and you're wearing a Velcro suit.
Oh, I'm catching up from behind.
Oh, yeah, for sure you can jump onto that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Okay.
I'm glad we settled that because
that worked.
That worked.
Hey, well, this is going to kind of lead us in. Well, I won't let it lead us in. That's being a pro, Jake. How about Chirinos, dude? 2 homers.
Yeah, but he's getting helped with that sticker on his bat. The magical sticker.
Yeah, that's right. So.
Yeah.
So they don't count.
Did you see what?
Well, we talked about Chirinos.
So. That was odd. I don't know if anyone saw it. Like something fell off his bat. He just picks it up and pockets it and tells the ump. I didn't think it was in any way a cheating allegation, but it was definitely different. And Razzball on Twitter was like, hey, what fell off his bat? Like, it looks like a sticker. And then someone said they put like the commemorative like sticker type thing on because he hit a home run the game before and he just didn't take it off. World Series thing. Yeah. Like this bat hit a World Series. That was odd. But yeah, back-to-back home runs. First guy to do it since last year. So that's a stat not worth sharing. But they shared it for sure. But pretty cool. I don't like Trinus's beard. And I don't like the quotes he said. Thought he came off like a dum-dum, but happy for him. And did he get a lot of concussions? Why does he wear such a weird catcher's helmet?
I don't know. I feel like we missed that. There was a cool, 10 years ago that like catcher's helmets became just a free-for-all? Like the hockey mask was allowed, and then some people still had the old thing, and it was kind of. Like, it felt like every series you saw a different catcher's mask, and that was kind of exciting.
I hate the hockey mask catcher's mask.
Sorry, dog.
Not a fan. I feel like that was John Flaherty's era. Like, he liked that a lot. I'm going to Google Chirinos catcher's helmet because it's got like an extra wall of padding in front of his forehead and it looks weird.
Okay.
I wonder if he had a concussion.
Mariznick, 2-for-4. Good for you, dude.
Yeah, I like Mariznick.
How about, I mean, I don't know. You could tell, I just mentioned that Rendon did his thing kind of, but there wasn't too much support around him. Altuve, 2-for-5. Brantley, 3-for-5. Bregman, 3-for-5. Five RBIs, most RBIs in a World Series game by a third baseman, Jim. You like that?
Most RBIs in a World Series game by a third baseman.
Correct.
No, I don't really care. I mean, that's cool. If Bregman finds that cool, I'm happy for him. But I don't really put a lot of stock into it. Like one game?
Yeah.
Was it 4?
5.
That's cool.
All right.
If it was just 4, it's like you just hit a grand slam. One home run got you him. So
yeah.
It'd be cooler if it was multiple. I'd even think it was cooler if it was 5 spread out through 3 at-bats than 5 spread out through 2.
Nobody cares.
This isn't something. That's what I'm saying. No one cares about this. If Bregman takes pride in that, I'm happy.
Good
for
you, Bregman.
Yes. So what's going to happen? You want to move forward to this next game?
Yeah, I'm trying to think if there's anything else. Houston bullpen. I mean, when they got the rally versus James Soto, bases loaded, and then he grounds out, that kind of felt like it.
Yeah, I mean, the home run was it. The grand
slam. But that was before that.
Oh, you think it was over before that? If it stays 4-1, if it stays a 3-run game going into late innings.
I mean, it was 4-0, bases hucked for Soto. If you're the Nats, you're already saying like, oh, he's about to go yard. We tie this game at 4s. When he grounds out and then Harris gets Kendrick too, which, again, kind of circling back to where we started this series. I mean, you know, the depth of the Nationals lineup is lesser than Houston's. And Will Harris mows down Howie Kendrick.
Yeah. But, in the later innings, there was the Astros gave up base runners. And if that's a 4-1 game, maybe it plays out differently. Like, there was 2 on in the 7th. There was 2 on in the 8th, right? 2 on in the 8th. Like, they still had the makings of putting something together. But it was a 7-run game after the grand slam, so.
Little, too late.
The Jake Storielli story.
Yeah.
Well, that's exciting, though, because that means you're going to do something cool soon.
You gave Corbin some junk. I mean, should Corbin get a lot of... I don't know if it's dislike or does Corbin get the blame for this? I mean, they only score 1 run.
He looked pretty bad in the first. Single, single, single. 4 singles in a row, then a walk. The ground ball, the double play, like, really helped him by Chirinos.
Yeah.
Because it was looking like a bad first inning. I don't know. He settled down. He had, like, a 9-pitch second. It was only 2 runs. But then the walk to Correa and the home run to Chirinos, like, it's bad. It's bad outing. You want more from Corbin.
Yeah. Yeah, Chirinos. That was the definition of a hanger. That was a bad one.
Yeah. All right, let's take a quick break, then we'll talk about game 5. Game 5, Jake. And now, baseball's built on 3-game series during the regular season, Jake. Did you know that?
I think so.
I think you kind of could have figured it out if you hadn't.
Some 4s, some 2s, yeah.
Mostly 3s. Now
saw that 5-gamer to end the year. What was that, Phillies-Nats?
That was wild. So the Nats are built for this. So a 3-game series now, kind of fun. And to open it up, you got Garrett Cole versus Scherzer, 2 Cy Young. Has Garrett won a Cy Young yet? He's probably going to win it. Scherzer's won one. 2 top 3-tier pitchers. This is going to be a fun game. I mean, this is the intensity for the Nats to win this game with Scherzer on the bump. At home, pressure is fully on the Nationals.
Yeah, that stadium has to be nothing short of raucous.
Raucous.
Rakus. But yeah, we've talked about, like, we said it in the Grinky game, Grinky versus Anibal. We're like, okay, yeah, if we had to guess this game before, you'd say, I don't know, Grinky does his job, Anibal gets touched up a little more than them, and we'll kick it to the bullpens. This one, I mean, if you're not rooting for basically 8-inning shutout from each pitcher, you're kind of not a baseball fan.
Yeah. Well, there's some people that don't enjoy pitcher's duels. I think there's plenty that do. I am rooting for both these pitchers to just hang their nuts out and go like
right, though,
crazy.
If you're a baseball fan and it's Cole Scherzer, I mean, you're rooting for double shove.
Yeah. Maybe the over-under we're rooting for, Jake, is 4. Under 4.
I was hoping you'd put it at 3.
I was thinking about it.
I saw you thinking about it.
But if it's like the 8th inning and both those pitchers empties the tank and they both turn a 2-2 game to the bullpen, we just got 8 innings of, like, fun.
Yeah.
So that's why
I
went 4.
That will be the interesting thing to see, A, where we go with all these playoff games. The first inning, that's going to be your best chance.
B,
scoring runs in the other innings.
Yeah.
That would be your other best chance. No, and you wonder, I mean, does small ball come out? Is there...
It should.
If the only rally is in the 6th inning and Garrett Cole's at 96 pitches and there's one out, 2 runners on, are they going to pinch hit for him? I mean, vice versa for the Nats and Scherzer.
Who's going to do more to help their team with the bat? Scherzer or Cole?
I think Scherzer. I think Scherzer can give a tough at-bat when he wants to.
So we're
both have some good NL experience, Cole from his Pirate days.
Okay, here's how it works, Jake.
Okay.
You get a point for every pitch seen.
Okay.
Okay. If you get a base hit, you get 3 points.
So I can go down and watch 3 pitches.
If you get a sack bunt, you get 2 points.
I can see 3 pitches, and that's the same as a base hit.
Okay, so a base hit's got to be worth... That's a good call. Base hit's got to be worth 5 points.
Kind of. I know where you're going with this, but it's not...
Yeah, base hit's worth
not
5
good
points.
At all.
Sack bunt's worth 3. Each pitch is worth 1. Who's going to outscore the other at the plate?
Oh, this old baseball game that people love playing.
Dude, National League fans, this is when you hear National League fans say they're playing fantasy baseball, this is what they're playing.
Right. Just scoring it home to themselves. Yeah, I don't care at all. I'm interested to see,
Make your pick.
With the Astros teams throughout the years, as we've been seeing them as the Yankees, we've seen different approaches. We've seen them try to take pitches to get Verlander and Cole out of the game. We've seen them attack early because that's your best chance. Do you think both teams are trying to just attack early and hoping they get something, or is it try to milk them?
Attack early. You have to.
Yeah.
If you let them go deep in the count, like, they're going to throw 120 pitches anyway.
Yeah.
So and the odds that they dice you up increase if you have more pitches seen in the at bat. Unless they're off, unless Cole, like, can't find the zone or Scherzer can't find the zone. But if they're on, you have to attack early.
If you're the Nationals, no one can touch the ball in this game besides Scherzer, Doolittle, and Hudson.
Yeah. I mean, you really would Scherzer just go until he can't throw anymore.
Yeah, when you just said both of them are going to get 120, that just got me excited.
Well, they're both not going to be able to pitch again in this series, right?
I mean, Game 7 heroics, you know, mad.
They're both not
going to
get a start in this series. This is
correct.
Their last start. So, yeah, they're throwing until, if they're on, they're throwing until they can't throw anymore. That's fun.
It's exciting.
Yeah. And also the whole at-bat fantasy scoring. That's
right,
also
at bat fantasy. Okay, so three. So if you see six pitches, that's better than actually getting a hit. And
yeah,
then,
but who sees six pitches or pitcher? That
is a run just 1 point? Because I think that'd be funny.
Okay, a run was 1 point, yeah.
Run is the same as one pitch, okay.
who cares? That's up to someone else. I've got Scherzer winning 8-7.
8-7, huh?
Yeah.
Damn, bold.
No, it's got to be more than that. He's going to get three
at-bats.
It's got to
be a lot more than that because you said
it's gonna be
a
three
pitch at-bat. Is a point, basically.
Yeah, he's going to be three at-bats. He's going to see one is going to be a 1-2-3 strikeout. That's three. One's going to be a strikeout. That's with another ball. That's seven. One's going to be a sack bunt. That's 3 points. So that's 10. So Scherzer's going to win 10-8. And you've got Cole winning 1-0?
I don't care. Okay. I haven't cared about this.
This is crazy.
Yeah, it is.
This is
no, not in that
exciting.
Who do we want to be heroes tonight?
Not Chirinos.
All the guys we like. Is it the like? Yeah, not Chirinos. Is it just our like list from yesterday?
Yeah. Well, you like Springer. I don't. I'm indifferent. Give me Bregman. I like Bad Boy Bregman being the hero again. I think they took it too far when they intentionally walked to get to him. I think Bregman just didn't sleep that night, stared at himself in the mirror, and was like, they intentionally walked to get to me? Intentionally walked someone to get to me?
Fernando Rodney.
His girlfriend or whoever was like, come to bed, Alex. So they intentionally walked someone to get to me, babe. You think I'm going to sleep? So
you think Bregman lets a girl in his hotel room during the World Series?
Yeah.
You're out of your mind.
I don't think. Okay, Buck Johnson says he wants the hero to be Zimmerman. Obviously, we'd love that.
Yeah, we're Team Zimmerman. Yeah, I think he would be number one on the... Like, if you had to pick one guy to hit a game-winning homer, it's either Zimmerman or Parra.
Oh, my God. Will they play it after Parra does something?
I mean, if they do, that's unfair. That's too much of an advantage.
I think you start Parra. You give him one at bat.
Okay.
Let the baby shark fly. Maybe start him lead off. Give him one at bat. Baby shark to open up the game. Cole hates it. And then
Cole hates baby shark. And
then you replace him in the field and set the lineup the correct way the next time through.
You know who kind of likes baby shark?
Verlander.
Granky.
Oh yeah! Did you see that video of him and his son like meeting in the hallway? That was cool.
Real nice.
You're the biggest Cranky hater in the world, so.
I wouldn't say that.
Show everyone your diary.
You, beer diary.
Yeah. Beer diary. I hate Zach Cranky. I just showed everyone.
Okay. So yeah, there's a lot of fun heroes on Washington because I mean. And Soto, 21-year-old Soto could really use it.
Oh, yeah.
We did Zimmerman. Parra would be a real Hail Mary, but that'd be cool. Scherzer or Cole getting a big hit, but we already went over the scoring system for that.
Yeah, there's a scoring system in place. Yeah, give
Your
me
Your number
like,
one guy that you'd want to be a hero on Houston is Bregman?
Altuve, and then Bregman.
Okay. Yeah, I think Altuve.
I like that guy.
He's cool.
Yeah.
Our size.
Yeah. And then Zimmerman's probably my number one choice across the board. Mr. National coming through.
Yeah.
That's pretty wild. All right.
Now I'm rooting for that. I'm rooting for and I want Gerrit Cole's last hitter to be Ryan Zimmerman. Like pitch 118. Zimmerman's up there giving an old warrior at bat.
I am firmly rooting for the Nationals in this game. I was rooting for the Astros the last two. Firm because if the Nationals don't win this game, it's a six-game series.
Right.
And I want a seven-game series.
Right. Because if you, you needed the Nationals to win yesterday for that.
Yeah, I know. You don't think the Nationals have a chance today.
I read
your diary. It was like beer diary. The Nationals have a chance to win today. Yeah, right. And I like Zach Greinke. Okay.
Getting snippy
with your diary.
If Max Scherzer goes out and pitches 8-inning shutout, I mean, we're not going to be here tomorrow being like, you're kidding me.
You're kidding me. Is that Max Scherzer, every single pitch looks like he's just going to die. I don't know how the pitching coach or Dave Martinez like knows when Scherzer's gassed. Because from the jump, I'm like, his arm's falling off on every pitch. He looks like a classic like Disney movie when the aging pitcher, like Kevin Costner in For Love of the Game, when he like at the end of this perfect game, he just can't throw anymore and he's like just like hurting. That's what Scherzer is just like, I'm gonna empty the tank every pitch, coach. Like,
yeah.
You got a lot of career left, man.
It's genius.
All right. That ends the show. Unless you got anything else to say.
I don't think so. I'm rooting for whoever's down in the seventh inning.
Nice. Thanks, guys. We'll see you tomorrow to recap whatever the hell happens tonight. Bye.